It's every girl's dream to win a beauty contest, dance with the Kilgore College Rangerettes, and to become a Dallas Cowboys cheerleader. Nora Taglegano got to live out those dreams. Nora was born and raised in Far to Oscar and Juanita Tagle, and was a middle child of three kids. She attended Longoria and Ramirez Elementary Schools, LBJ Junior High, Memorial 9th Grade Campus, Piaget High School for 2 years, and then she graduated as part of the first class from Piaget North High School in 1993. That same year, Nora was named Miss Far. She went on to Kilgore College, where she joined the world-renowned Rangerettes and received an Associate's Degree of Arts in 1995. She then transferred to the University of Texas Austin and graduated with a degree in theater and dance in 1997. Going to school at Piaget is an experience that Nora recalls fondly.
It's something I always am proud of. It's something I always brag about. I always say, PSJA breeds the best people. They breed the best dancers, is what I always say. I tell everyone that. The teachers were great. They cared about you. They took you under their wing. They made sure that you got all your work done.
Nora learned early on that dance was what she was going to pursue as a career.
Ever since I was a little girl, my mom had struggled so much to put me in dance class and put me in modeling classes. And she sacrificed a lot for us to do this. Since I was 7 years old, I took dance at Greta Sullivan School of Dance. And took dance all the way through high school. I knew I wanted to dance. I knew that's what I wanted to do as my career. It was my love. It was my passion. I did it all the time. I was at the grocery store and I was, moving around. My mom kept saying, stop, stop, don't move. Anytime a song came on, I was dancing. I just knew since I was a little girl that I wanted to dance.
Currently, Nora is Executive Vice President for the Rio Grande Valley Vipers.
My main focus is corporate sponsorship. So I am working with sponsors from, let's say, from Stripes, from HEB, from Academy, just different places, corporate sponsors, and also local corporate sponsors. And we just make sure that everything is getting fulfilled, that any promotions, any advertising that they want to do with us, that we are following through with all of that.
She goes out of her way to make sure that all our clients, all our season ticket holders, sponsors are happy.
Following her passion, she is also executive director for the Snake Charmers.
Which was a great great experience for me. It was very different being on the other side as a director when I was so used to being the performer and the dancer and didn't have to worry about anything but my dances. So being on the other side has been a big learning experience from the first year and to where I'm at now. This is our fourth season.
Nora traces her success as a Rangerette and Dallas Cowboy cheerleader to her roots at PSJA.
Being a Bearette and a Raiderette, both with Miss Navarro and Miss Vela, was a good training for me in going on to being a Rangerette, which I think being a Rangerette was the hardest thing I've ever done. It was way harder than being a Dallas Cowboys cheerleader. Miss Vela and Miss Navarro are really good at being disciplined. It was almost like being in the military with them. You walk in a straight line, you don't touch yourself, you smile all the time when you're on the field, your hands are behind your back, you're looking up at the audience. So it was great training. It was good, so I was prepared when I got to Rangerettes from, doing high kicks and the discipline and everything that came with it.
With hard work and determination, Nora was able to achieve her childhood dream of becoming a Dallas Cowboys cheerleader.
Wow. I can't even express the feeling of pride of accomplishing your dream. I mean, I remember when I was a little girl, we'd watch the Cowboys games at home, and me and my cousins would wear the jacket that said Dallas Cowboys cheerleaders in the back, and we'd dance around and we'd, have our pom-poms and cheer, and all we would do is look at the girls in the background and look at the cheerleaders. So to finally get to that point in my life was an amazing experience to accomplish your dream.
It's rare when a child knows what she wants to accomplish and through hard work and a good education was able to do just that. Nora is now in a position to advise young people to follow their dreams.
She believes that nothing is impossible and everything could be accomplished.
Everyone has their own special talent. I think you need to dig deep inside of you, see what makes you happy, see what passion, what you're passionate about. And pursue that as your career. I mean, it's so important to be happy in what you do in a daily basis. It comes full circle. Find your talent and pursue that in your career.
Participating in extracurricular activities wasn't just something to do after school for Nora. It set the foundation for her work ethic later on in life.
Being in extracurricular activities was, I think, a great thing for me, the best thing I've ever done, really, because it helped me to learn for now in my job and everything I do. It helped me to balance both my work and my dance, and, you know, if I was in student council or whatever else that I did in the theater, the shows that we did.
She brings that same determination not only to her office, but also to the dance team that she's part of the coordinator for.
After marrying her high school sweetheart, Michael Gano, and the birth of their son, Aaron Justice, Nora realized the importance of being close to family.
We decided, you know, we need to come back home. This is where the family is. This is where we should raise our children. And have him around his grandmas and grandpas and everything. And the support system here for us has been great. I mean, I would not be able to do the job I do right now if I didn't have my family around me.
With all the experience Nora's acquired over the years as a dancer, she hopes to help others fulfill their dreams.
It's been a great experience trying to breed and instill everything that I have learned in Dallas and in Kilgore into these girls, and trying to breed them into amazing dancers so they can go on and follow their dreams of being a Houston Rocket dancer, a Spurs dancer, or a Dallas Cowboys cheerleader.